gold and select me set up, which is consistent with the gold that they had given to us last year, is that we do everything we can to maintain a full range of services being provided by the general government to the citizenry of the government. We've succeeded in that in the sense that a lot of the services that are presently being provided in this fiscal year will be eliminated or substantially diminished in FY93 as a result of the budget that we proposed. They asked us to prioritize capital spending. What they meant by that was to give some serious attention to the ongoing replacement of capital equipment and maintenance of capital facilities such that the time of major assets are not unduly wasted during this period of low economic health. And finally, and perhaps most importantly, the selectmen asked us to address the weaknesses that we have identified and recognized over the past year in our service delivery. We began doing that last October. One of the most serious and significant things that this town has done in the past 7 years is to establish an account and appropriation for it in the October town meeting that is designed to pay the compensation of permanently disabled police and firefighters prior to their retirement. And when I say prior to their retirement, what I mean is that a police officer or firefighter who is injured on the job and is going to be retired on the basis of that injury carries with him the obligation on the town's behalf to pay that person on the job until they retire. Prior to last October, those payroll or those labor costs were paid out of the departmental operating budgets. And for those of you who were here with us last October, you may recall that this account was set up to pay them out of a different account so that the police and fire departments could maintain a full complement of working personnel who would be able to provide the better quality service with more consistency to the community. That's one of the weaknesses that we've addressed. In the budget that we're facing right now for FY93, we're looking at several other areas. We're looking at the finance division. That's an area where, most recently, we've had some very high-profile weaknesses in, and there's been a great deal of public and private discussion about them. The budget that we're putting forth attempts to address those in a way that we think is going to not only be productive in the short term, but it's going to be very beneficial for the community in the long term. In the town administrator's office, we're attempting to address a couple of weaknesses. One is under compensation of one of our staff people who is performing a job which is well beyond the job description that applies to the position. The other has to do with the addition of a human resources coordinator, which is identified in the award as a benefits coordinator. I'm going to get into that portion of the budget in more detail. There's also an appropriation for a secretary, it's shown in the award as a full-time secretary, but in the motion that we'll debate tonight, it will be a part-time secretary, so it will be dedicated to the activities and support of the Board of Selectmen for the Federal Town Administrator's Office. A great deal of discussion and debate, it was finally concluded also that we would address a weakness in our building department and general building enforcement area by engaging a full-time building inspector who also would be responsible for the overall coordination of our various building enforcement areas. And then finally, in a broader enterprise budget, you'll see a couple of weaknesses addressed. We'll discuss those when we get there.
Stop there.